going live now, I think. We're live. Guys and girls, how you going?
Bondi.
Bondi Radio. Hey, download the app, Bondi Radio app, and you can listen to us live.
Stories in there that I learned, like I lost one of my chapters in the book is called losing your ego, and I lost it on that mountain. And that's why I've really found it. It's a great photo in itself, but it's part of the book in it as well, part of the few stories. So I wasn't plugging my book, it's just exciting news. Yeah, exciting news. So I'm very, very excited. Alice and Nancy helped me write the book. She should be putting her name down there as well, because she helped me out a lot with that. And we've got another guest. Who's another guest?
Yeah, Mark
that's not really got us to be drinking beers down here on a Saturday. Yeah, you're doing. But what have I done this week? I've had an awesome week so far. The first thing I did, I got a job. You know, it's an industry that I'm passionate about. And it's taken me a couple of months to get that job, but it just fell on that Monday. Tuesday, the same day actually, we got the puppy.
Yeah.
You know, we got the puppy. Oh no, we've got the, they said we have it.
Okay.
So that's another thing that was been draining. Just a lot of things I feel in my life that have been dragging me out. Nothing's been eventuated into anything. And it's just all happened at once. And I'm just challenged. I want to ask this question, whether it's the fact that I've changed or has it's just a lucky week. Because on Tuesday, I got my Australian citizenship as well. Well, I didn't get it. I got it on Thursday. But Tuesday, they I called them up and they said, yeah, we've got a ceremony going to be on the Thursday. I know I sound Aussie, I should be an Australian citizen, right? I've been here 27 years and I've just never got around to it. But, you know, that's the third thing that happened. And the fourth thing that happened, is the book came on Friday. That's been dragging me out for 8 months. Now, what I was looking at, and this is what I want to relate back to wellness, and the question I want to ask is that the fact that I got back from England and the fact that I got back from overseas in Europe and I was, you know, letting myself go a little bit, not too much, just having a couple of glasses of wine, having a pizza, having a pasta, you know, just enjoying my meal all the time, letting myself slip into my discipline, coming back and not having that great headspace, you know, having that head fog, and then coming back and just deciding, you know, having that discipline that I'm going to do something for the next few years, I'm going to do something in my health, but my nutrition, part of my nutrition, it starts in my fitness, it starts with alcohol and water. Supplements, which is things that are great, and I'm just wondering whether it's the supplements and the new nutrition plan around that, like no sugar, not much sugar in my diet, and no carbohydrates, no pizza, no pasta, sorry, mama, sorry, mama, and no alcohol, obviously, and what that's done, I'm getting up earlier. And what that's done is getting training. What that's like doing is that it's a supplement, whether it is a supplement or not a supplement, I'm not too sure, you know, because I wasn't told it. But is it the fact that I'm off sugar and I've got, I don't have a fuzzy mind anymore, because it is a different. I want to share it with you. We talked about, you know, no sugar here, right? I want to share something that I just had a thought on the way here, how I can approach it and how I can chat about the whole sugar versus carbohydrates. Think of fuel in your car.
Yeah.
Right? What fuel do we put in our car? Petrol.
Yeah.
We've been doing that for how many years? We're in that for many years? 80, 100, 100 years? Or, I'm not too sure.
I think the T4.
So we have petrol, right?
Yeah.
And the other side of it now, that well, if you think of petrol, there's a byproduct that it's causing havoc to our environment. Does that make sense? So I look at it like the new age now is like electric cars coming out, sustainable energy. It's the same thing in our body.
Yeah.
Like we've been having carbohydrates and sugar in our system, and the byproduct of that is faulty mindset. I'm coming from me, my own test up. I just had that realization that it's like having petrol versus an electric car, like having carbohydrates and simple sugar versus having a high fat diet. You know, it's just something that you're
trying to change.
So, what about that on this morning?
I love your energy. You know, for people who are trying to get their blood sugar to get back to
one beer and one glass of wine, and I felt bad.
Yeah.
I felt like in my head, I felt like I had a headache.
Yeah.
Because I had nothing for, what was it, 21 days now from the way back?
Yeah.
No sugar, really shit, like nothing. Just, you know, just the meats and eggs. And,
so you're following the keto?
Ketone.
Ketone.
Yeah. High fat, high protein. And what the supplement is for myself. like that little bit of a fasting meditation, you know, like a detox meditation process. And I don't eat, so like I haven't eaten yet. And that's unlike me as a growing boy.
Oh my goodness, you're drinking coffee. That is the worst thing.
I'm gonna eat you.
Seriously, Liam, you have to have at least an apple or lemon water, because when your body is
Oh no, I have water. I have lemon water as well. Yeah, definitely. I'm in a big meal. I should have explained myself. I'm in a big meal in terms of the lemon dollar meal. We haven't sat down to eat yet. So what I consider a meal is different. What I consider eating is different than what you consider eating. So
I like your style.
Yeah. So I'm really excited about the week, and that's what I want to share with you guys. It's the fact that I got on the phone and spoke to the citizens who has hassling them over the last few weeks to get me in this week, changing my thoughts, hassling them from America to get it over here this week. You know, hassling the dog lady to get us, and we all fell on that the same week. Does that make sense?
Yes.
So it's the fact that I've been motivated, or it's the fact that the nutrition's motivated.
I don't know what came first, but I love your energy, and we have
Yeah, we've had a great family reunion. Yeah, that was awesome. So
I think it's you, and I think it's the dogs. You're inspiring me. I did my three stairs challenge with you.
How'd you go?
Oh, hard, but you were in my ear, and I was present, and I did it.
Awesome.
Hi, darling!
Come here!
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good, how are you?
Good.
Yeah,
gone live in 2 minutes with Alice and Nancy, my book writing coach, and she's a 11-time author, I think it is. So have any questions for her, please feel free to jump in, guys. We're offline now on the Bondi Radio show, so we're not on at the moment, obviously, so I'm just here chatting to you guys. So just be a fly on the wall, just watch us in the background, see us make any mistakes, and if you have any questions, feel free to jump in and download the app, Bondi Radio app, at the iTunes store.
I'm going to put the camera on.
My kids do, and it refers to the sun. Something like that. So yeah. Oh sure, I'd love to.
Track. Yeah.
there's some tips in. I'm sure she's got like on day 26 or 21 or something like that.
I'm always I'm writing books, I've got tips. At the moment I want to start this kind of 21 tips to meditation made easy, so that it's just to show people that it really doesn't take that much. And a lot of people, the first people think people say, how do I do it? My mind wants to stop resting, I'm doing right, how does it have to be? So I show in 1 minute next week. And I just share one tip today. So one tip, this is my career tools. So some of them are my tools and some of them are tools that I've learned along the way over 20 years. But my kinesiologist, Deborah B. Fuji, she taught me this. This is called Air Hold 3. So if anyone's interested in watching me do this. So I do this with all the kids in the workshops. The teachers walk around and I can't do it. So basically just, you know, one hand over your head, one hand over back. Example, Tony, my agent, has got five phone calls this week, all going together. well is get your kids to self-regulate through morning meditation or night meditation. It certainly can be like a nice relaxing meditation. I like what almost really takes my turn. Just download one for a dollar and just listen to my bedtime meditation. And that will allow you to relax. So that's what we're doing. I'm just using the word meditation for children. I mean, we didn't have our word meditation, and I had to discover it myself. And now the children, the younger generation, have this tool that they can tap into that they know about. And I said,
well, give an example of that actually, because I ran a lot of stuff with girls, and really about empowering the girls. Like, I did kind of want to mention someone as well, so I think I'm going to give a shout out to her. She's my creative partner in the Color Girls series, and she's also one of the novel I've written.
Wow.
Yeah, and so Pip Pomerantz is the champion and now the director of the movie. Kind of just basically get it from the book to the screen. Okay. Very excited about
That's
that.
Awesome.
So, yeah, so she and I do lots of collaborative stuff there together, but Pip, and she's really all about girl power and martial arts. She's over in LA at the moment, but something I do back home, so I've been doing lots of inspiring girls workshops in Bondi, in the Central Coast, in Boca, and around the traps, and then I had this boy, this mum texted me recently, and this boy was really stressed. What had happened was he had gone into the AFL field and accidentally injured someone. He was carrying a stretcher, and this boy was really stressed about that. Not really enough to tell him, I sent him to his mum. He's really kind of anxious, and she was kind of like, you know, but she, because her sister had gone to my next workshop, so she got down and she did it, and in the end, tried a few different things. She said, I just said, look, and then he was saying, come up to a workshop with Alison as well.
Yeah.
It's just that thing of taking the space to as well, and she loves to have a voice. Yeah, so it's kind of addictive as well. I mean, once you start, you're like, wow, there's not a day that goes by. And I would say something about meditation as well, just so you could do, you know, visualization, belly breath, or therapy meditation, and find your voice. Now, find your voice that comes from your voice or something. The last thing I do is like the sort of songs or songs. You know, where you're trying to learn to meditate. It's stressful. Don't do that.
Did you meditate during pregnancy?
Yes. Both had that one. So, my daughter was 30 hours old, which was excellent. And she was posterior, so basically that means for men, that means for us. There's no refrain, But I meditate, and I didn't stick with the birth. So at one stage, she wasn't really kind of coming out very quickly. And I was doing this hip and birth technique, and that's the midwife that I was doing this, because it was in the hip. But it's working, just keep doing it. And that was this hypnotherapy versus visualization. In fact, the very last hour was like 3 hours later. And then the midwife, she was still doing this meditation and visualization stuff. And by after 24 hours, like, give me the job. Give me the job. Anyway, but it only worked for half of my body. So I'm there until half of my body got out. So then she had to do this visualization technique. Helped me to feel in my body through my mind. Like, feel it. Very bizarre. She said, I'm going to use flower. Just allowing the baby to come out. But it was this full on exhibition. And then I was visualized, and that allowed my body to actually feel in my mind. And then my son, a year later, which was like enough to labor on the office. But I meditated for 5 hours, and it was 5 hours later, and it was Yeah. When they were little, I'm not
Just a